Shining in the spotlight requires that you have something to say. We head to Johannesburg for a history lesson with a singer who has the soul of a rebel and the voice of an angel.
Describe yourself in one sentence.
Crazy beautiful.
How would you describe your sound?
It is the sound of all my pain and all my joy.
Favorite place in the world to perform?
South Africa, home.
Hi, my name is Thandiswa, and I'm a musician from Johannesburg, South Africa, and this is my Africa.
Thandiswa exploded onto the South African music scene in 1998, at the age of 22. As part of the group Bongo Maffin, she was a pioneer of Kwaito, a South African form of hip-hop. That sound, seen as a form of social expression, emerged as the country was on the cusp of democracy.
We started to represent something a little bit more conscious, something that was a little bit more cognizant of the time and the political environment that we were in. My story is one of a black person growing up in apartheid South Africa. How to navigate that? How did I survive that? It is also the story of a black South African in what is now the new South Africa. How do I navigate that? But it's also a story of great celebration, a story of great joy. I'm a mother. I'm a musician who travels the world and sees beautiful things. That's my story. I write about that.
Her journey began as a child on the streets of Soweto.
Soweto is a neighborhood that was created by the apartheid government to remove black people from the city center. So it was created as a place where black working class people would live. Most of my childhood was spent here. I had a very happy childhood. I grew up with both my parents. I grew up in a community. The thing about growing up in Soweto is that community is very much, very important, very much a part of your life. Your next door neighbor is where you might go and spend the whole afternoon after school because your parents are not there yet. You might eat at someone else's house, somebody might eat at your house. So my parents were both academics and they were both writers, journalists. So they kind of instilled the love of words, the love of books, but also a very deeply entrenched love of politics and just kind of the thinking, the consciousness of our position as black people in apartheid South Africa was built in this house.
It was in this environment where she found her voice.
I never imagined I'd become a singer at all. So I knew that I had a love of it. And that there was something about music that made me feel free, that made me feel like I was being myself.
Today, Thandiswa is one of Africa's most celebrated artists and has performed all over the continent, sharing the stage with world-class musicians.
African textiles are everywhere, African art is everywhere, African music is everywhere. Africa is all around you, you just have to accept it and see it for what it is.
Thandiswa represents her Africa, not only in song, but also through her personal aesthetic.
I love to put on like jewels. I have a lot of African jewelry from all over the continent, so Maasai jewelry, Fulani jewelry, Ndebele, a lot of South African jewelry. It's really about merging a lot of like the really deeply tribal stuff with something very, very modern.
From her look to her music, this artist resonates with the masses.
In the beginning, I remember one of the older artists saying that I felt like something from his time. He said, you just feel like something from Sophia Town. You remind me of the girls I used to like when I was young. So I think the older people kind of felt some resonance with me because of that. Some of the things that the young people say is that I gave them a sense of identity.
And her sound transcends genres.
We were at the vanguard of the Kwaito movement, so that's something. But we were also at the vanguard of the kind of Afro-pop, Afro-soul movement. I've always felt myself to be a conduit, someone who hears something from some mythical place and then brings it forth, you know. So I don't think of it as my own personal talent, but that through me a story needs to be told.